Hi students, in this class I am going to tell about methods of increasing the CMRR ratio. I am going to tell about methods to increase CMRR ratio. So in yesterday's class we are already done the AC analysis of differential amplifier using H parameters. In this class I am going to tell about an AC analysis of differential amplifier using R parameters, a small d. Okay, in this AC analysis of differential amplifiers using H parameters, already we derived the H parameters by using the differential gain, common mode gain and the CMRR ratio, input impedance and output impedance. In this class R parameters, I am discussing about an R parameters. RE means RE. No need to find out the derivation part for the R parameters of AC analysis of differential amplifiers. We have to remind the formula of these for the R parameters of the AC analysis of differential amplifier. You are no need to find out the derivation part for the R parameters of AC analysis of differential amplifier. You just remind these formula which is useful for in the problems you are going to solve. Okay, this is the formula for the RE, R parameters of AC analysis of differential amplifier. If in the problems only it is used for solving the problems. If in the problems HIE value is given, so it is an R parameters. It is an R parameters related formula, related problem. If HFE value is given, it is an H parameters related problem. So in the problems, if HIE value is given, we are using this formula. If HFE value is given, we are going to use the H parameters, that means H parameter derivations of input impedance, output impedance and the CMRR, and what we have already derived the differential gain and the common mode gain. If HIE value is given, we are choosing these R parameters derivation, and in H parameters HFE value is given, we are going to take the H parameters derivations of a differential gain, common mode gain and the input impedance and output impedance and then the CMRR ratio. So no need to find out the R parameters values of AC analysis of differential amplifier. We must find out the derivation part of an H parameters of AC analysis of differential amplifier. No need to find out the R parameters. We just remembered the formula for R parameters here. So if HIE value is given in the problems, it is an R parameters related problem. Then HFE value is given, it is related to the H parameter problems. Okay. Then this is about the R parameters of AC analysis of differential amplifiers. Now I am going to tell about how we will improve the CMRR ratio. Okay, by using various methods we are going to improve the CMRR ratio. This is one of the topic in unit 1, methods to improve CMRR. If we improve the CMRR, it is a good differential amplifier. It is one of the feature of the differential amplifier. If CMRR ratio is high, it is one of the good differential amplifier. It is one of the most performed differential amplifier. So here if we are going to choose the CMRR ratio high, so we have to improve the CMRR ratio by developing the various methods. By increasing that CMRR ratio, we are using various methods to find out the increasing of a CMRR ratio. How you will increase the CMRR ratio? In this class I am going to tell you. So methods to improve CMRR, there are many methods to follow, two or three methods to follow the increment of an CMRR ratio. In this class I am going to tell the how to improve the CMRR ratio. CMRR ratio is the common mode rejection ratio. You already know what is the definition. Common CMRR means common mode rejection ratio. In this common mode rejection ratio, it is the ratio between differential gain to the common mode gain. In this it is written as it is the ratio between common mode differential gain to the common mode gain. Here common mode gain if common mode gain is zero, then it is having CMRR ratio is value is very high. So only we are depend on the AD and AAC. It is the ratio between differential gain to the common mode gain. So CMR ratio is common mode rejection ratio. It name itself consisting of an common mode rejection ratio means it rejects the common mode. It rejects the common mode gain. It rejects means completely zero. AC value is completely zero. AD value have something value have. Okay na? Differential amplifier having something value, but AC is rejects by the in the CMRR ratio. It is completely rejected by common mode. In name itself consisting of common mode rejection ratio. It rejects the common mode gain. It rejects the common mode gain. AC means the common mode gain. AC means common mode gain. It rejects the common mode gain. So its name consisting of a common mode rejection ratio. We take only differential gain and rejects the common mode gain. Okay, next. If CMR ratio is high, it gives a good performance. If CMR ratio is high, it gives good performance. CMR ratio is one of the feature of CMRR is one of features of differential amplifier. Differential amplifier. If CMR ratio is high, it gives good performance. That means if differential amplifier CMR ratio is high, it gives a good performance. So we choose that CMR ratio value is very high always. So here we have formula for CMR. If CMR ratio is high, it gives good performance. And we are selecting the differential amplifier. If CMRR is very high, it gives good performance. So we are choosing that type of differential amplifier where CMR ratio is very high. So what is meant by CMRR? It is the ratio between differential gain to the common mode gain. In name itself, it rejects the common mode gain. So we always choose that AC value is equals to zero. So when AC value is equals to zero, CMRR is very high, obviously. So to get AC is equals to zero, it depends on the emitter resistance. Already we already know that in a common mode operation, RE value is more in common mode operation. We have already seen in classes. So RE value is infinite. It is when AC is equals to zero, RE value is very high. Okay. So here, but RE value is not high. If AC is equals to zero, then we consider RE value is infinite. If we already know that CMRR means AD by AC. AD by AC means if CMRR means AC value is equals to 0. So AD by we consider this 0, then we get high value of and CMRR. For getting high value of CMRR, then we consider AC value is equals to 0. For getting AC value is equals to 0, we consider RE value is infinite. Like this. So when we have already known that CMRR is equals to AD by AC. AD by AC, that means CMRR is directly proportional to 1 by AC. CMRR is mainly depends on the AC. So here already derived that AC is equals to HFE RC by RC plus HFE. So 2RE of 1 plus HI. So from this AC value is equals to 1 by RE. If AC value is equals to 0, then we consider RE value is infinite. But it is when AC value is equals to 0, RE value is infinite. It is inversely proportional to they. So, but here RE value is not high. RE value is not high in the circuit. We already draw the circuit for the differential amplifier, basic differential amplifier. We already know the what is the circuit diagram for the basic differential amplifier. It consisting of two transistors and the emitter resistors. Okay. So here when RE value is infinite, RE value is not high because of it follows the some limitations. It has limitations. If RE value is high, if we consider RE value is infinite, then it follows some problems. Like when RE value is, for getting an AC value is equals to 0, by getting CMR ratio is high, it follows the circuit having some limitations. What are the limitations when RE value is high? When AC is equals to 0, when CMR ratio is high, circuit follows some limitations. What are the limitations? What are the drawbacks when AC value is infinite? Means when AC value is infinite, it has to follow higher values, needs more biasing voltage to set operating points of two transistors. What are the drawbacks of when RE is infinite? When RE is infinite, it value, RE value needs more biasing to set operating points of a transistors. We are going to set the two transistors operating points by providing more voltages to the two transistors. And also the overall chip size is increases. When RE value is infinite. These are the drawbacks. Followed by the circuit. So when CMR ratio is high, it has to follow AC is equals to 0. When AC is equals to 0, obviously R is infinite. So if the circuit, if RE value is infinite, then circuit follows some drawbacks. What are the drawbacks? It needs more biasing to set operating points of two transistors, and also overall chip size is increases. So for avoiding these problems, we are going to take another methods for increasing of an CMR ratio for good performance of an differential amplifier. So here, without increasing the RE value, we are choosing another methods for increasing of an RE. So when we are choosing another methods, no need to biasing voltages for setting of an two transistors, and overall no need to increase the size of an chip. So we have to follow various methods without disturbing the circuit and without providing another voltages, more voltages to set operating points of transistors. So I am going to tell you about what are the methods without disturbing the overall chip size of circuit, and also we don't put the more voltage to set the operating points of the two transistors. I am going to tell another methods for increasing of an CMR ratio. Okay, then instead of taking RE value very high, we have different methods without disturbing operating points of transistors and chip size. The methods are constant current bias methods and constant mirror circuit or current repeated circuit. We have the methods without disturbing the RE value. Instead of taking RE value very high, we have these are different methods. So these two are the different methods we are going to learn. What are the methods? Constant current bias method and the constant mirror circuit or current repeated circuit. Constant current bias method, and another method is constant mirror circuit, or it is also called as a current repeater circuit. Current repeater circuit, constant current bias method and the constant mirror circuit or current repeater circuit without disturbing the RE value, without taking the RE value. Instead of RE value, we are taking these methods by avoiding the chip size, and also we have to provide more voltages to set the operating points of the transistors. In avoiding these drawbacks, we are going to take these methods for increment of an CMR ratio, for getting the good performance of an differential amplifier in the circuit. So, constant current mirror, current bias method and the constant mirror circuit, or it can also called as current repeater circuit. In today's class, I am going to tell about one method, that is a constant current bias method. I am going to analyze the constant current bias method circuit. So, you know about improvement of an CMR ratio without disturbing the RE value. So, in this constant current bias method, the name itself consisting of a constant current. In the N-type circuit, the current is flowing is in constant. So, in the N-type circuit, current is constant. N-type circuit, IC, foreign is IC, IE and IB. So, in this current IC, IE and IB, there is a following current flow in the circuit is constant. So, I am going to tell about the first method, constant current bias circuit method. I am going to give the circuit analysis of the constant current bias method. In this, this circuit is placed instead of RE, which provides constant current and has high input impedance, high input resistance. This circuit is placed instead of RE, which provides constant current. It is a main point, constant current bias method. So, it names is a constant current. It provides constant current and has high input impedance. In heading name, constant current bias method. That's why it provides, the circuit provides constant current and has high input impedance. So here is the circuit. I am going to, it is the circuit for the constant current bias method. I am going to tell about the circuit analysis of these constant current bias method. Finally, we want constant current from this circuit. So, I am going to tell voltages and current equations. So, first of all, I am taking voltages and current equations for this circuit analysis. So, from this circuit, I am going to tell you about the circuit analysis of this circuit. So, instead of an RE value increment, I am going to tell about a constant current bias method. So, here, from this circuit, this is a transistor, this is a resistor, this is the one of the circuit which is taking instead of RE by the from the differential amplifiers. Instead of taking RE of the differential amplifier circuit, I am going to take R1, R2, R3 are the resistors rather than RE, instead of RE. Okay, constant current means name itself consisting of a constant current, flowing of a constant current. When emitter gives that current, in collector it gives that current only, constant current. Okay, so in this I am going to solve the circuit analysis. So here in this first of all Q3 has a beta value very high. Beta value very high. Q3 has a beta value very high. So here Q3 has beta value very high. We know that the formula for the beta with the name equals to IC3 is equals to beta IB. I am going to solve the constant current in the entire circuit. So, I am taking only current values and the voltage values here. Okay. So, here I can write like this. IB3 is equals to, here current is in IC3, IB3 and the IE3. R3, R2, R1. I1 is the current and Q3 is a transistor. Okay, IB3 is equals to, can I write like this, IC3 by beta, then IB3 is equals to 0. So IB3 is equals to 0. We have a formula, IE3 is equals to IC3 plus IB3. So IB3 is equals to 0 means IE3 is equals to IC3. Okay, then I am going to take the value of current in the circuit. So from this VB is equals to, I can take only voltage values and the current values. From the circuit I am going to take VB is equals to VB is equals to minus I1R1. This is the first equation. Okay, this is minus I1R1. I want to use this voltage, base voltage, in like next derivation part. So I placed here in first equation minus, this is the I1, this is the R1, minus I1R1. Okay, plus to minus means we can take I1R1. So here VB is equals to I1R1. Next I am going to take the I have formula for the VB is equals to VB minus VE. From this I am going to tell what resistance of an emitter now. So I am going to take the VE is equals to VB minus VBE. VB minus VBE. This is an second equation. Next I am from the circuit, from the circuit, IE3 is equals to V equals to IR now. So V is equals to IR means I am going to take only V by R. So from the circuit IE3 is equals to V minus of minus VEE by minus VEE by R3. So from this IE3 is equals to VE plus VEE by R3. This is taken as a third equation. Okay? Here it is an VE, no need to confuse. Okay, from this circuit VB is equals to minus I1R1. It is an first equation. We have already formula VB is equals to VB minus VE. So here taken out as an VE, I only want emitter voltage. So emitter voltage equals to IB minus IBE. This is taken as an second equation. Okay, then here from the circuit I am taking only emitter current. So emitter current is equals to V is equals to IR. We have formula, then I is equals to V by R. So I can write here IE3 is equals to VE minus of minus VEE. Minus of minus, it is close from positive to minus. So minus of minus VEE. So by R3 resistance in this by taking this circuit, IE3 is equals to VE minus of minus VE by R3. We have V is equals to IR na, I is equals to V by R. So we can write the formula VE minus minus of VE by R3. So VE plus VE by R3. This is taken as third equation. So from this circuit, from the input loop, we are going to apply the KVL law from the input loop. Apply KVL law at input, we can get I1 R1 plus I1 R2. I1 R1 plus I1 R2, the current flowing entire loop is I1 and R2 minus VEE is equals to 0 minus VEE is equals to 0. So from this we can write like this now. Voltage emitter VEE is equals to, we can write like this now. VE is equals to I1 of R1 plus R2. So, continuation in this place, okay? What we can get here? VE is equals to I1 of R1 plus R2. So, taken I1 out, then we can get VE by R1 plus R2. Okay? We can get. This is right. So, we have already VB is equals to minus I1 R1. So, we get the I1 value. So, substitute this I1 value in first equation. Substitute I1 in equation 1, I am going to substitute I1 value in the VB. So, VB is equals to, I1 means VEE by R1 plus R2. I1 plus R2. So, I1 plus R2, VE by R1 plus R2, and I1 means minus I1 R1. So, minus into R1. Minus there na? Minus I1 R1. So, VB is equals to minus VE by R1 plus R2 into R1. This I am after you. So, then we have already VE value here. From the VE value there na, VE value there. So VE value we have already VE value. So we can get VB value na. Here we are going to derive the VB value here. From the second equation, we have substitute substitute VB value in equation 2, we can get VB means, what is VB? VE is equals to IB. IB means minus VE. Here VB value there na, substitute in second equation. VE plus by R1 plus R2 into R1. And we have minus VB. And minus VB. Okay, next. I get VE value. Okay, here I have an v value here. I am going to solve this substitute this v value. I am going to substitute this v value in third equation. So I can get IE3. IE3 is equals to substitute in third equation. Substitute v value in third equation. No need to confuse. It is very simple equations. Okay. Substitute v value in third equation. I can get minus VE by R1 plus R2 into R1 minus VBE, and also in VE I have plus VE by R3 plus VE by, I am going to show this final equation. So plus VE by R3 here. Okay. Then IE3 is equals to minus VE. Simply I am going to substitute VE value in equation 3. In equation 3 I can substitute this VE value. So then VE value is gets like this. So simplify this IE3, then we can get that answer. Minus VE R1 minus VBE, take this R1 plus R2, VBE R1 and minus VBE R2 plus VEE R1 and plus, I can write here, VEE R2 by R1 plus R2 by R2. Then here some terms of get cancelled. Minus VE R1 plus VE R1 gets cancelled. Then we can get this equation. What the equation? Minus VBE R1 minus VBE R2 plus VEE R1 by R1 plus R2 by R3. This is the equation. I am going to simplify this equation also. Okay. Then this is R2. Sorry. This is R2. Then we can get the equation like this. So I can write here. No need to confuse. IE3 is equals to current. IE3 is equals to emitter current. IE3 is equals to, from this, minus VBE. Minus VBE is taken out. Minus VBE is taken out. I can write here R1 plus R2 plus VEE plus VEE R2 by R1 plus R2 by R2. It can also simplified like this. I am going to write here. Okay. IE3 is equals to VBE R2 by R1 plus R2 minus V minus VBE by R3 minus VBE by R3. This is the final equation of your constant current. So here I am going to take the only constant values. I am only my entire concentration on the for getting an constant current, IE3 is equals to IC3, then it is CMR ratio is very high, it is a good performance differential amplifier. When CMR ratio is very high, obviously it is a good performance differential amplifier. For constant current, my aim is in this circuit analysis, constant current bias method. Constant current bias method means we have to put the current in the constant for the entire circuit. So for this, I am going to take IC3 is equals to IC3. IE3, that means current is constant. By adjusting the values of R1, R2, R3 and VE and VBE. Okay, by adjusting the values of R1, R2, R3, VE, VBE, we can get the constant current here. Constant current IE3. When IE3 is a constant, obviously IC3 is also constant. Our aim is to get the constant current by using these R1, R2, R3 instead of RE. By taking RE very high, the problem of this circuit is overall circuit chip is size of this circuit is very high, and also it wants to provide high voltages to get the operating points of transistors. In order to avoid the drawbacks, I am taking here two methods, constant current bias method. In the constant current bias method, our aim is to get the constant current IC3 is equals to IB3. Obviously, from the first onwards, IB3 is equals to 0, so IC3 is equals to IE3. Our aim is to get the constant current in the circuit, IC3 is equals to IE3. So here, I am adjusting the values of R1, R2, R3, VBE and VEE by R3 by adjusting the output variables. So I can get the constant current, IC3 is equals to IE3. Okay, so it is the, by simplifying these equation, we can get these equation. I can write here, by simplifying these equation, we can get a VEE of R2 by R1 plus R2 minus VBE by R3. Okay, I am going to explain from first onwards. No need to, there is no confusion in the circuit analysis. Okay. Our main aim is we are going to we want to improve the CMRR. For improving of CMRR, it depends on the AC value. By AC value is common mode gain value 0, then obviously RE value is infinite. But practically RE value is not high because of RE value is not high because of circuit designing complexity is very high, and also it wants to provide high voltages to set the operating points of transistors. In order to avoid that the drawbacks, I am implementing the constant current bias method and the constant mirror circuit here. So by using constant current bias method, I am circuit analysis with the constant current, and it has a circuit has a high input resistance. Then by using this circuit, I am going to tell the circuit analysis of a constant current bias method. In the constant current bias method, I am going to tell you the circuit analysis once again. I am going to take this circuit. Once again, I am going to repeat the derivation part of a constant current bias method. Our main aim is to provide the constant current IC3 is equals to IB3. Why? Because IB3 is 0, so we can take IC3 is equals to IE3. For getting the constant current, this is a circuit analysis of the circuit constant current bias method. So, in the place of an RE, I am taking R1, R2, R3 instead of RE for the avoiding the drawbacks of using RE. So here I am taking this circuit for the derivation of an constant current bias method. In this I can have VB is equals to, from the circuit this is the VB. VB is equals to minus I1R1. So here this is taken as first equation. It is used in another derivation. So VB is equals to minus I1R1. So we have formula VBE is equals to VB minus VU. We have standard formula VBE is equals to VB minus VU. So I can take out the VE. We want the voltage of the emitter. So I want to take out the VE value is equals to VB minus VBE. Taken it as in second equation. Now from the circuit we can write V is equals to IR formula from the circuit, from the emitter I want to take the current of emitter IE3 from the circuit. This is IE3 from the circuit. I have formula V by R. So VE minus of minus VE by R3. So IE3 is equals to VE minus of minus VE by R3. It's from the circuit. This is IE3, this is VE, this is RE, this is minus VE. So IE3 is equals to VE minus of minus VE by R3. So from this circuit I can write like this. IE3 is equals to VE plus VE by R3. This is taken as third equation. By applying KVL law at the input. By applying KVL law at the input loop, I can get this. I1 is equals to I1R1 by applying KVL at the input I1R1 plus I1R2 minus VE. Is this a input loop? This is a input loop. So I can take here I1R1 by applying KVL here I1R1 plus I1R2 minus VE is equals to 0. So here simplification of this, I want only VEE. So taken out VEE for substituting this VE value here. So I can take the out VEE is equals to I1 of R1 plus R2. I have in the terms of an I1, I want I1 to substitute this I1 value in the first equation. So I1 is equals to VEE by R1 plus R2. We have from the first equation, we have VB is equals to minus I1R1. So in the I1 is substituted in equation 1, I can get in equation 1, I am going to substitute I1 value here, then I get IB. VB is equals to minus VE by R1 plus R2 into R1. So here substitute, I also have the VB value. I also have VB value. Then I can substitute my VB value in second equation. So in second equation we have V is equals to VB. I substitute VB value here. I can substitute VB value here from the second equation. Substitute VB value in equation 2. I can get IE is equals to minus VE by R1 plus R2 into R1 minus VB. Then I also have this VE value, the VE equation, VB minus VBE. Okay, then VE is substituted in equation 3. In equation 3, I am going to substitute this VE value here. Then I can get substitute VE value in equation 2. In equation 3, I can substitute my VE value here. Then I can get IE3 is equals to minus VE by R1 plus R2. R1 minus VBE plus VE by R3. From VE, so from this we can get VEE R1 minus, subtract by simplification this, VEE R1 minus VBE R1 plus VBE R2 plus VEE R1 VEE R2. VEE R1 and minus VBE R1 gets cancelled. By simplifying this equation we can get VEE R1 minus VBE R2 plus VEE R2 by R1 plus R2 by R3. then simplify this equation, we can get here this equation, and the final output by simplifying this equation we can get IE3 is equals to VEE of R2 by R1 plus R2 minus VBE by R3. Here we can get the constant current when we adjust the values of VEE, VBE, R2, R1 and R2 and R3. By adjusting the values of resistors R2, R1 and R3, VBE and the VEE, we can get constant current in the circuit. So we can write IE3 is equals to IC3 by adjusting the values of R1, R2, R3, VBE and the VEE. So this is the constant current bias method. In the name itself, it has a constant current bias method. By avoiding the RE value very high, we implement these methods, constant current bias methods and the constant mirror circuits or the current repeated circuits. This is about constant current bias method. In this constant current bias method, we are going to constant the currents. IE3 is equals to IC3 is equals to constant. So this is about a constant current bias method. In tomorrow I am going to tell the another methods there na, constant mirror circuit or current repeater circuits. I am going to tell the constant current mirror circuits or current repeater circuits, okay, in next class. I am going to solve the one problem which is based on the operating points of the circuit shown in the below figure. So here I have a circuit. I am going to solve the problem for the operating points of the transistors. We have a circuit solving these ICQ is equals to VE minus VBE by RS plus beta plus by beta plus 2RE, and also operating point of the voltage VCQ. Already we already read the operating points of the transistors VCC minus ICQRC plus VB. So from this circuit we have n values. RE is equals to, this is RE na, 3.3 kilo ohms. We have RC is equals to, this is the collector resistance, 4.7 kilo ohms, and we have values VCC is equals to VE is equals to 12 volts. VCC and the VE is equals to 12 volts. We want to find out these VCQ. What are VCQ? VCC minus ICQRC plus VE. We have formula VCQ. We want to find out the VCQ, VCC minus ICQRC plus VB, and also the operating point of an current ICQ is equals to ICQ is equals to VE minus VB by RS by beta plus 2RE. Okay. I am to find out the VCQ operating point. VCQ is equals to, then I am going to solve the ICQ value of the operating point of the transistor. ICQ is equals to VE minus VBE by RS plus RS by beta plus 2RE. So here I am taking the silicon resistor, silicon transistor. For the value of silicon transistor, we have VBE is equals to 0.7 volts for the silicon transistor. So substitute these values in this VCQ and the ICQ, we can get the operating points of the transistors. So ICQ is equals to VE means 12 minus 0.7 by RS by beta is Rs by beta is ignored because of it is very smaller than 2Re. So I can neglect here Rs by beta. 2 into Re means Re value is 3.3. We can get an answer 1.716 millivolts. It is a current now, so units is on millivolts. So then I am going to solve the operating point of ICQ. ICQ is equals to V ICQ naught. I am going to solve the VCQ. VCQ is equals to VCC there now. 12 minus ICQ means 1.716 into, in the form of an millivolts, I can convert this into volts. 10 power minus 3, 1 millivolts is equals to 10 power 3, 10 power minus 3 volts. So I can write 10 power minus 3 into RC. RC value there now, RC is 4.7 kilo ohms. 1 kilo ohm is equals to 10 power 3. So I can substitute here 10 power 3. Plus VBE. Plus VBE means it is a silicon resistor now, 0.7. So here the value is 4.653 volts. It is a voltage now, so the units is in the form of a volts. It is V. Okay, 4.653 volts. This is about the problem. We want to find out the operating points of N2 transistors. The problem is we have one circuit. We want to find out the operating points for this circuit shown in the below. We have operating points for the transistors ICQ and VCEQ. We have operating points of ICQ and VCEQ for the transistors. Okay. This is the circuit diagram which is going to solve the problem. So here this is a formulas ICQ for the problems VCQ. So here I want to substitute the given values in my formula for find out the operating points of the transistor. So Re is equals to 3.3 kilo ohms, RC is equals to 4.7 kilo ohms, VCC is equals to 12 volts and the VE is equals to minus 12 volts. You can put mod here. So we can get 12 volts. So it's the formula VCQ for the voltage operating point, for the current operating point. We already know about the operating points of the transistors. So here I am taking the transistors of an silicon transistors. Here transistors are silicon. The value of VBE for the silicon transistor is 0.7 volts. So here I can substitute in the place of an VBE is equals to 0.7 volts. So I can take this formula ICQ is equals to ICQ is equals to 12 VE means 12 volts minus VBE means 12 VBE means silicon transistor na, so 0.7 by 2 RS by beta is ignored. 2 into this is ignored, so neglecting this 2 into RE means 3.3 kilo ohms. Then we can get the current value 1.716 millivolts. Current value in the form of an units millivolts. So here voltage operating point VCQ is equals to VCC means 12 minus of ICQ means we can get value here now 1.716 into millivolts is converted into volts. 1 millivolts is 10 power minus 3 and into 4.7 into 10 power 3 plus 0 point VBE means 0.7 for this silicon transistor. This is the answer for get these voltage operating points. Okay, then this is the problem for getting solving of operating points of the transistors. In by tomorrow I am going to tell you about an constant mirror circuit, which is also called as a current repeated circuit, by tomorrow. Thank you.